Hello friends, welcome back. In this session, we are going to understand how do we write simple Verilog code for the simplest of the logic gates. I'm going to take two gates today. One is going to be AND and another one is going to be NOT. That's all. I will explain how do we write the Verilog code, how are we going to run it with iVerilog, how do we write test bench for it, how do we validate it. All this will be done in this 15 to 20 minute session, and you can follow step by step. I will explain you each and everything. We can grow deeper into it a little later, but this session is meant for teaching you the fundamentals of how do we write the code for the electronic components and the digital devices with Verilog. That's it. It's very simple. Let's take AND gate first. But before going into coding, we need to understand some very fundamental things. The most common and the most fundamental building block in Verilog design is called as a module. You can see that here. This is the module that I am talking about. This is the most fundamental building block, which means this forms the basic entity. This is used to construct the design. You cannot have nested modules. Remember it, I cannot have a module inside another module. And most important point is you can construct a circuit only with the module. Means a module has got everything inside it, like the gate, the register, whatever you want, whatever electronic components you are thinking about will all come under one package called as module. So module is inevitable. Let's take a simple example. As I told you, we are going to write the code for AND gate. You can see that here. I'm going to zoom a little bit so that you can see that easily. Now you can see that here, module AND gate A, B, Y, and I have closed it. Remember it, I have closed it. This is the module. The name of the module is AND gate and it has got A, B, Y. What is that A, B and Y right now? Very simple. A, B and Y are nothing but the ports. The ports can be input port or output port. Now you can take this diagram as a reference and see that A and B are nothing but the input and the output can be Y, which is what I am referring as Y here, and say A, B here, it can be Y. Assume this as Y. Now A and B are called as the input ports. They are separated by comma and you need to have a bracket here for sure, and you can have it in any order, don't worry. A, B and C, that's the way you need to write it, and you can have it in any order. B can come in the front, A can go to the next, don't worry about that, and it's not a problem at all, because we are going to say which are all the inputs and which are all going to be the outputs in the next step. So what is the next step? The next step is going to be very simple, where we are going to understand out of this A, B and Y, which are all going to serve as the input and which are all going to serve as the output. Now I created a module called AND gate, and in that I have got three ports. Two of them are called input and one is output. So input are going to be assigned as the A and B. The output is going to be assigned as the Y, and these two steps are done. That's all. I'm going to stop it here and I'll go to the next slide where I'll talk in detail about the assigned statement. What is it? Till now what we have learned is we learned how to declare a module, how to pass the arguments to it, what are the arguments to it, like in the C programming, and how do we assign something as input, how do we assign something as output, and the final processing is yet to be done, which I have not yet done till now. Now, remember, I told you, you can have any number of inputs, any number of outputs, but without having it clearly mentioned here in the ports, in the bracket here for the module declaration itself, you cannot use it. This has to be remembered. Now, another point that you need to remember before we go into assign is the N module. The N module is the one which says that the module is all completed and the work is over. The code is over. That's all what we are saying, right? And remember, rest all statements had semicolon. You can see that here, there is a semicolon, there is a semicolon, semicolon, semicolon. But here, there is no semicolon. It is very important to have an N module without which you cannot have the module closed. It's like opening a loop and closing it. So have it closed properly, and the N module is very important. Now what is assign? I told you, assign is the final process that we are doing. That's the function. So assign is the work that the gate is going to do. Assign Y is equal to A and B. This is the operation that we are doing for the AND gate, A and B. Now see that the A will be ANDed with B and the result will be connected to Y. That's all. It's very simple. And this is the way we have created a module. This is the simplest module for AND gate. Now, sir, will it give an output, sir? No, it won't give an output. What you have constructed is an electronic component, but you need to write a test bench for it to work. you have created an AND gate in Verilog, but you need to pass input to it and see if the output is coming as you expected, and that's where we need test bench for it. So what is a test bench? Very simple. We need to have a test bench to test if your code that you have written is working. I mean, the circuit that you have designed is working. What do we have in the test bench? Very simple. You will have inputs as 0, 0 for an instance, and what would be the output? You will say you have already created the electronic circuit, so you will pass this input to that circuit and see if the output is coming as expected. If it is not coming as expected, you can understand it's a failure. So a test bench is something which is going to help, going to be very helpful to us towards understanding if the design that you have made is successful. And remember it, writing test bench is most important than writing module. It's the way I will tell you, because you need to test your design, and if it is not proper, you can catch it via test bench. Test bench should be extensively written. You should have practice on that, and without fail, start practicing that as well. It's very, very important, and I will tell you how exactly to do that. There are other couple of things that we need to remember. One is wire, and the second one is the very important thing that is called register. We are going to use these two terms in the test bench. We are going to use the term wire and the term register, REG, in the test bench. So what is it? Wire is called a data type, and it belongs to net data type. A register is called a variable data type. That's it. What is a wire? A wire cannot store value. The output from the module is what is going to be sent into the wire. Its value is determined by the module output. Remember, whatever output your module is going to give will be coming here, but it cannot store it. So it's going to be non-storage, but its value is determined with the output from the module, or it's an output from the gate, like that. It's going to be driven by something else is most important to be remembered here. And now next, what is register? A register is meant for storing. So you can store something here, and remember, it has to be inside some procedural blocks, like the initial block, which we are going to talk about right now. I have presented a very simple yet a very important test bench for the AND gate that we have designed some time back. We have written the code, the module for AND gate. Now what we are writing is, we are writing the test bench for it, and I have given line by line explanation for the test bench, which is very self-explanatory, but still I will explain you step by step. Now what is the name of the module? Module is everything here, as I told you. I am writing a module for AND gate, and it's a test bench for it. So what do? I need to write it as module AND gate underscore test bench. Please follow the naming conventions properly. It's very, very important. Since the previous module was named as AND gate, this module should be AND gate underscore TB for conventional purposes. Now remember, what is the output? The output is Y, T underscore Y. There it was Y, here it is T underscore Y, because it is test bench. So I follow this convention. And why do we call it as wire? I told you, wire is something which is driven by something else. Here, the module's output is going to drive it, which is going to be coming inside the result T underscore Y. Remember it. We need to have wire as the output. Now, what is the input? The input registers are T underscore A and T underscore B. They are registers. Remember, they are registers. T underscore A, T underscore B are declared as registers. T underscore Y is declared as wire. Remember it. Now what is it? We have created a module called as AND gate sometime back. You can see that here. I'm going to show you that again. This is the name of the module that we have created, AND gate. So what do? We need to instantiate that here. We need to create an instance of AND gate here as my underscore gate, and you are going to connect A in the AND gate. A was one of the inputs in the AND gate as T underscore A. B was one of the inputs. B is going to be connected as T underscore B. Y was one of the outputs. Only one output was there, by the way. So Y was the output, and it is connected as T underscore Y. That's very, very important. Now this part is over. We have just created the fundamental stuff here. We have created what is the T underscore Y, which is wired. What is T underscore A and T underscore B, which is a register. And we have named the module appropriately. And also we have instantiated, which is a very important point to remember. And that's done. Now, what do? We need to go into the test scenarios. I mean, what are all the inputs for this AND gate? What would be the output for it? What are all the input parameters? A and B are the inputs, which are related as TA and TB here. So I need to set the values for it. I need to set what is the value. All those things are going to be pretty clear here. And that's what I'm going to give you right now. Now, it starts with initial, and I need to begin it. It starts with initial. See, very important point to remember here is, If the code is to be only executed in the beginning, we can write them using the initial block, right? The code is to be executed in the beginning and we can write them using the initial block. Initial block starts executing once the time starts with zero. The time has to start, right? So begin is starting here and monitor. This is a very important point to remember here. What is monitor? I will keep monitoring you is what I'm telling you when I'm evaluating you. Monitor is going to display variables whenever there is a value change. If there is a change in TA or TB or TY, this monitor will display it out. That's all. We need to use monitor like a printf statement where we will get the output displayed when there is a change. That's it. Now, can we go to the test scenarios? I'm going to go with one by one test scenarios right now, which is very, very important. So please understand this. All these are very easy. So we have just created it. We initialized it. We went for begin and monitor is given just to track the changes in each and every variable out there. Now we get into TA underscore TB with the values. This is all one bit. So with the values 0, 0. 0 and 0 are the input values for the first attempt. Now after 5 nanoseconds, I change the values as 0 and 1. It's B represents binary 0 and 1. And after 5 milliseconds or 5 nanoseconds as per regulation, I change it as 1, 0. And finally, after 5 nanoseconds, I make it as 1, 1. So it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So once this input is coming, there is a change in value. So I'll get the output displayed along with the inputs being displayed. Now there is a change in value again. So I'll monitor it and it will display. There is a change in value again as 1, 0. That's how I display it. Now what has happened? I have opened this module. So I need to end the module. For this module, I'm closing it here. For begin, I need to end it. The begin is to be ended with end, whereas the module has to be ended with end module. Remember it. Now what we are going to do is I'm going to show you the demo of this, as in how do we combine all these together. I have got two files now. The first one is called as the and.v. This is nothing but the module for AND gate. And the second one is called as the test bench. So we have these two files available with us, right? So how do we combine them together? How do we compile them together? That's most important, right? So that's what I'm going to show you right now. And please follow it up carefully. As usual, I have gone into the C drive where I've got iVerilog installed. And inside that, I have got bin. Let's see if my files are all there. All my files are available here. And what am I going to search for? I'm going to search for and underscore tb.v. So I need to now combine them together and I need to compile. How do we do that? Very simple. iVerilog hyphen o. Let's call it as and underscore gate. This is the name of the executable file. What are all the two files I have? And.v and underscore tb.v. And these are all the two files that I want to compile. Now what I did is I gave the option o, which will get the object file of these two. And that will be converted as an executable file. And the executable file name is and underscore gate. Now we can run it. DVP and underscore. Sorry. VVP. You can see that the output is all available here. 00 for an AND gate gives you 0. 01 gives you 0. 10 gives you 0. 11 gives you 1. That's it. Very simple. Can we take another example, another instance, and then try it out? I'm building a NOT gate right now with my Verilog. So for the NOT gate module, I've got only one input and one output would be there, and that would be inverted. So what is input here? The input is nothing but A. The output is nothing but Y. And what I'm doing, I'm using assign here with Y is nothing but NOT of A. That's all. I opened the module. So I'll have to end the module with N module. Let's go to the test bench. So what is the test bench name? NOT gate underscore TB. So what is the output? Output is T underscore Y. Earlier it was Y here. So I take this as wire and it is T underscore Y. So the input is nothing but A there. So it is taken as register here and T underscore A. Now I need to create an instance of this NOT gate out here. So I have created the instance as my gate. Now A there is treated as T underscore A and Y there is treated as T underscore Y. And I go with initializing the module there. I go with initializing and then I begin. I monitor the values T underscore A and T underscore Y. Whenever there is a change, I'll display it. So what are all the rules? Very simple. The first case, I'll have input as 0. So the output should be 1. Second case, after 10 nanoseconds, I try the input as 1. Can we try compiling it? We will do that right now. Let's run it. iVerilog hyphen o not dot v not underscore tb dot v. I'm sorry, I did not give the name of the executable file. That's a mistake. See it. Not is the name of the executable file now. Now we will run it. Vvp not. Very simple. 0 will be converted as 1 and 1 will be changed as 0. That's it. We got the output. That's it. So what we learned today in this session, we learned how do we write a simple Verilog code for simple couple of gates. I didn't take further gates, which we will learn a little later. Maybe in the next session, we will go with the next set of gates. But this is sufficient for you to understand how do we structure it. That's the most important point that you need to remember. And I hope it was useful. Thank you very much for following my channel. The content, if you like, give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, suggestions, please go ahead and type it in the comment sections. I'll be able to answer you. Thank you.